Hello students, I am Sachin Prakash and I teach and mentor students in chemistry for IIT JEE. I believe that the real confidence which is required to crack this IIT JEE exam will come only when you are confident in tackling good problems. And that clarity and understanding of concepts will only develop when you are really comfortable in handling these problems. So this video contains the paper discussion which I have recorded conducted in my classes online. Okay, and a lot of good doubts are there which I have discussed here. It will be helping you people in understanding, developing an understanding in how to approach and tackle good problems. Okay, and if you like this, you found this paper discussion video to be useful and interesting, you can like, comment and subscribe to this channel, which will surely motivate me to add some more useful paper videos of this type. Okay, because ultimately it's this is just an effort, honest effort, small honest effort from my side to help the student, help my students as well as other students also in their IIT JEE preparation. So let us begin with this paper discussion. Okay,
so now we are live and today we are going to discuss UTM 9, okay, which is a paper which is based on GOC isomerism up to and in GOC up to reactive intermediates. Okay, and this is a paper in front of you. It is having some questions of optical and geometrical isomerism, and rest of the questions are from, yeah, please switch off your video feeds, okay, so that it will be easier for me to discuss the paper. Yes, okay, so as usual, we'll be starting with the numerical value questions first. So 71, 72, any doubts?
So 71.
Yeah. In 71, you see the idea is that you have a phenolic group and you also have a chiral carbon because it is rotating the plane polarized light. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
So one second.
See, in 71, what are they saying? They are saying that you are having a compound which rotates the plane polarized light. Means you have a chiral carbon? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now it is connected to four different groups. One of them, those groups is a phenolic group. Now, how does a phenolic group look like? It would look like something like this.
Yes.
Okay, now I can put OH here, here or here.
Yes,
sir. So ortho, meta and para.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so suppose this is my phenolic group. Okay, now how many carbon atoms phenolic group is taking? 6. And how many oxygen it is taking? 1. So how many carbon atoms are left? 2 carbon plus 1 oxygen. Yes or no? Yes, no. Out of those two carbon, one of them is a chiral carbon. So only one carbon is left. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So that carbon will be in the form of CH3. That is the only possibility.
Yes.
Now one oxygen, yes, I have to put like OH and another as H. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
So this will have two isomers, D plus M. Okay. Now you will have two isomers for ortho, for meta, and for para. So it will be 2 × 3, it will be 6. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you have to do a bit of thinking here. Okay. 72 is easy. This time they have given a very clarity, non-bonding electrons, not lone pairs.
Yes, sir.
So this is 4. Okay, 73, the answer should be 2, not 4.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this should be going for a key change. Because, see, these are, if they have written chiral carbons, then the answer will be 4. But they are saying stereogenic. These are not stereogenic carbons because you cannot write the stereoisomers.
Sir, chiral means 2 only.
But we will be having 4 isomers, no, sir.
No, you'll be having 2 only.
Sir, you're having 2 carbons, right?
Yeah, but I have told you that you cannot write a configuration in which you can exchange the groups. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir. So, for each of them, we will be having D plus L, no, sir. Then it should be 4 only.
This we have already had that discussion, I think, in the class also. That yes. In this case, you cannot break the bonds at bridgehead carbon and write the exchange the groups because that will increase the ring strain. Are you getting a point? Okay, so in this case, even though it is having 2 chiral centers, these 2 atoms are not stereogenic. You cannot create stereoisomers by interchanging any 2 groups. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Then how we will have 2 isomers?
The 2 stereoisomers will be just mirror images of each other.
Yes.
This will not have any, this is asymmetrical molecule, not because of stereogenic carbon. It is because the whole molecule as such is asymmetrical. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
So here the answer should be 2 plus 0. It should be 2 only. Y is 0 and X is 2. But I guess the examiner is assuming that all chiral carbons are stereogenic, but that is not the case. I have given you the example of chiral astereogenic center also. Yes. Are you getting a point? And stereogenic a chiral carbon also. Do you remember it? Yes or no?
Sir, an example could you give again?
That one or this one. The pseudo chiral center example. In pseudo chiral center example, the middle chiral carbon will be chiral but
non-stereogenic.
Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So moving forward.
Sir, 74.
Yes, sir. Yeah, 74, the answer should be 4.
Yes, sir.
Have up, down. And this will have 2, E and Z. So 2 into 2, 4. It should not be 8. Actually, I think they have written number of stereoisomers. Because if you take optical isomers also, then the answer will come to be 8. Are you getting a point? Even 74 is going for key change. Okay. Then 75. 75 is not a doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, it is pretty simple, straightforward.
Sixth one, sir.
Fifth one. Here the negative... Sixth one. Fifth or sixth?
Sixth, sir.
Sixth, CH2 minus is delocalized by the minus M effect, no? Just draw it. You can delocalize it like this.
Sir?
Yes.
How is 4th and 7th ones connected?
4th, d orbital resonance. Sulfur is having vacant d orbital.
Yes, sir.
7th, also d orbital resonance. I think we discussed yesterday only, no? Clear, yes, no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Shall we move forward? Okay, yes, so 71 to 75 is done. Next, 68 to 70.
Sir, 68. Option D.
Yeah, it is optically active.
Sir, if we assume that ring...
It will never have a plane of symmetry. This is CST, this is H.
Sir, both are in perpendicular planes, no, sir? Terminal groups?
Yeah.
Sir, then we can draw a plane of symmetry in the plane of CH3 and H, no sir.
But see, even if you are drawing, compared, suppose this is up, there won't be a down CH3 group to match it, no?
Sir, down we are having that line, that is CH3 only, no sir.
Are you see, there is only one group CH3 which is attached to it, no? The other group will be hydrogen only. Yes or no? If you are taking the molecular plane of symmetry, current if CH3 is up, then is there a down CH3 to as its mirror image? Tell me, yes, no.
But to the next carbon, there is a CH3, no sir.
See, this will have the mirror image only at this position, no? If you are taking this. See, if you are taking this as the mirror image, then this is not having a mirror image. Are you getting your point?
So let me draw understand.
It. Yeah, let me draw it. You see? Okay, let me draw it like this. Okay. Let me draw it like this. Now is it clear? Okay. So now I will place as per your wish. Okay. First, molecular plane of symmetry. How will the molecular plane of symmetry look like? It will be something like this. Yes or no? Getting a point?
Yes.
If you put CH3 here, is there any mirror image of this CH3 here? Yes or no? Okay. If I put this here. Yeah, please
do. Saturday,
yeah, there is so much.
Next Saturday.
Okay. Now, if I put this CH3 here, still you don't have a mirror image?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Now, our best chance of getting a mirror image is in this position. So, if I take this as a mirror image, you know, something like passing right through the mirror, then this is having mirror image here, but this is not having any mirror image here. Are you getting a point? So there doesn't exist any plane of symmetry in this molecule. That is my point. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So answer is three only. Moving forward. 67.
Sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, 69.
Yeah. Let us do one thing. We draw, find the length of the conjugated system. So I will just count all the sp2 carbons which are in a series forming a conjugated system. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
It is having a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is it clear? This is having only one carbon. My conjugated system should carry, stabilize a positive charge.
Yes, sir.
This is having how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm starting with a positive charge only. And this is 1, 2, 3. So which is the longest carbon positive charge containing conjugated system? 1. Yes, so the answer is 1. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So after that, 67. 60, 70 is a doubt? No. It should not be a doubt.
No, sir. No, no sir.
Alpha hydrogen. Okay. 66, 67.
67, sir.
67, sir.
Yeah. You see, this is a Wilshov plus M effect. So it is stabilize the, you create a negative charge here, which is stabilize the radicals. Whatever stabilizes the carbocation will stabilize the radical also. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes,
so,
sir.
If you are talking about the order of stability, it will be 1 greater than 2, greater than 3, greater than 4. Yes, are you getting sir. A point?
Yes, sir.
66 is a doubt?
No, sir.
65?
No, sir.
Yeah. 65 no, sir. Is not a doubt.
Sir, option 3.
Option 3.
Option 3, sir.
Yeah, it is having 6 5 alpha hydrogen. What is the problem here?
Option 3, sir.
Naphthalene has 3 resonance structures. Naphthalene has 3 resonance structures.
You are asking option 3 or option 4?
Option 3, sir.
I thought you were asking this. Option 3, no. Naphthalene is having 3 resonance structures.
So equivalent resonating structures.
Yeah, without charge.
We have to take it like that. Resonance structures.
Last time also they didn't accept it. So it's better to follow their criteria only. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
There's no point of fighting with them when they are not agreeing. Okay. So going by that, they are asking the standard resonance structures, which you can draw. Not all possible. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
So I think the 3 resonating structures of naphthalene, I have drawn it here. Okay. Option 2 is not a doubt. I think you can calculate bond order between 1 and 2 and 2 and 3. You will get it. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So after this, 63 and 64.
So
if the intermediate is stable, then the bond will break easily. Is it clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That's it. Okay. Then 61, 62.
No, sir.
No doubts?
No, sir.
That's good. 59, 60.
Sir, in 60, once explain option C means C.
Option C. You see, in option C, you are having a, you can explain it by two methods. You can explain it by more number of pi bonds. You can also explain it by the octet rule. Getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I don't understand. Yeah. If I would have to have it out, I would have said B. But, you know, you are getting B, so it is very good. But C is very straightforward, no? More number of pi bonds.
So B, sir.
Yes.
In B, you see the negative charge is will be stabilized when it is nearer to the electron withdrawing group.
Yes, sir.
So all the other conditions are same only. Okay, 60 is done, 57,
58,
59.
58.
57.
58,
sir.
58, I have told you that benzene is behaves like a, what, di-radical.
Di-radical.
So these are not pi electrons, these are p electrons. They are sp2 free electrons. So electrons in p orbitals are considered to be the part of pi electron system, not in sp2 orbitals. Are you getting a point?
Yeah, that means all are sp2 hybridized and number of pi electrons will be 6.
Yeah. Benzene is aromatic, but that aromaticity is not helping the unpaired electrons in delocalization. These are localized electrons. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now 59 is not a doubt.
So it is due to back bonding stabilization.
Yes, yes, yes. 57 not a doubt.
So 57.
Okay.
So 57 explain.
See, 57 is something which you draw and you will get it. It's an isomerism question. Okay. See, the molecule is symmetrical. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Molecule is having a symmetry about this axis as well as this axis. Are you getting a point? Yes or no? This means that I have to only analyze one quarter of the molecule. So if I place chlorine here, 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 and here, these are the four possibilities.
Yes, sir.
Okay, because this position and this position are equal, this position and this position are equal, this position and this position are equal. If I say this is 1, 2 and 3, then this is also 1, 2 and 3. This is 1, 2, and 3. This is 1, 2, and 3. Are you getting a point?
Sir? Sir, in resonance, no, sir. I think we'll check for the whole molecule, even if they, if it looks like equivalent structure or something.
Where?
Like...
There's no resonance. They're asking isomers.
Sir, not here, sir. Like, generally, in this question, you took only half molecule, half of the thing and you...
This I am doing because this molecule is highly symmetrical and you have to find different unique positions. So obviously I can eliminate the non-unique position, symmetrical positions by through symmetry node. Like if this and this are symmetrical, this means whether I put chlorine here or here, it will make the same thing. So this and this are symmetrical. So whether I put chlorine here or here, it will be the same molecule. Getting a point?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yeah, okay, sir.
Okay. This is a different question. Don't put aromaticity here. Okay. After that, 56. Is it out? There is a symmetry here. And these two halves are equal. So this cannot be a chiral center. This is not a chiral center.
Geometrical stereogenic center, no, sir.
Stereogenic carbon. Stereogenic carbon.
Sir, which carbon?
This carbon she is talking about, right?
Yes, sir.
You are saying that this can be up and this can be down also, no? And yes, relative to this, because here you are having a lone pair, but here the lone pair can undergo inversion. That's why that's the problem. Are you getting a point? If all three groups are once combined again, together, see that this molecule can undergo inversion. Are you getting a point? But this molecule cannot undergo inversion. Getting a point? If you have a bridgehead nitrogen, it won't undergo inversion. But here, some amount of inversion is still possible because this CH3 is free. Getting a point?
Yes, sir.
So that is why this is not a center. Yeah.
Can't we say like both sides, I mean, it is symmetric, no, sir? They're ring carbons.
No, she is talking about geometrical isomerism, not optical isomerism. See?
Yes, sir.
You are getting a point. If I am having something like this, then obviously there will be always a plane of symmetry. So it cannot, it will be optically inactive. Are you getting a point? But this, yes, if I change these two groups, then I get a different stereoisomer or not?
Yes, sir.
So these are what you call as achiral stereogenic centers, which I talked about earlier also. Because by exchanging two groups, you are getting a different stereoisomer. In this case, that is geometrical isomer. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. So details are important in this question. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Moving up, 55.
Sir, 55 optical isomers. Optical isomers.
It will be having two optical isomers. For each geometrical isomer, you are having two optical isomers. So total number of optical isomers will be four.
Sir, okay. Can you say again?
For each geometrical isomer, you will have two optical isomers.
Oh, okay, sir.
So total is four?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay. 54?
No doubt, sir.
53? 53 is something which I can claim because acrylic is nothing. It should be acrylic acid, which is something like that. But personally, I'm not very happy with this question because it's a fact-based question. You need to know the structures of cinnamic acid, picric acid, and citric acid. Although I have given citric acid in the exam, I think IUPAC nomenclature, cinnamic acid
yes,
also
yes,
I have.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Do you want me to claim this question?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will try. Okay. 52?
Sir, 52,
sir.
Yeah. You see, this is group number 1. This will be group number 2. This will be group number 3. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 1. It is what? Anti-clockwise. But hydrogen is at what position? Horizontal. So, RS becomes R.
Sir, numbering if we give
sir,
from
numbering if we give from
2 is 3 and should be
1. One minute. Okay. They are assuming that numbering, whenever if we are taking Fisher projection, we generally do the numbering from the top. Okay.
But sir, parent chain will consider from bottom.
Yeah, that is your point, which is valid also. So this means that in this case, even 1 is correct.
Yes, sir.
If you are doing numbering from here, then 1 will also become correct.
But parent chain we need to consider according to IPS.
Generally, yeah, they have written the molecule in a bit different manner. Okay. Generally, you know, means when you write a Fisher projection, then we assume that the highest oxidation, highest, you know, priority carbon is always written on the top. Now, in this case, both top and bottom are CH3. Okay, so they have the same priority because they have the same oxidation state. Generally, if you have CHO and you have CH2OH, CHO is written on the top, CH2OH is written on the bottom. Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
And then numbering is started from the top. So based on that, they are saying it is 2R and 3S. But yeah, if you go by IUPAC nomenclature, it should be 2S and 3R. Right? So I would suggest both 1 and 2. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. I think 51 should not be a doubt for you people.
No, sir.
So with this...
Sir?
Yeah, tell me.
66 also, sir.
Yeah, 61,
that first answer, A.
Yeah, A. Then 61,
C and D.
Yeah. So, which is more stable? Backbonding stabilization is possible in C. It is more stable. In D, A, resonance is possible. It is more stable. Is it clear?
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
62?
Say 62 knots. I was about to say 61.
Okay. 66. Tell me, which one?
Sir, in A and B, both R and S are possible, sir.
Let me check.
Yes, sir.
A, propene is more stable than ethene. Propene is more stable than ethene. Okay. So R is possible. S is also possible. Actually, you can say
R is preferred over S.
But you see, R is preferred over S. That is the thing.
Sir, then in second case also, R should be preferred than S, no sir?
Yes, sir.
CH3 hold twice CH plus. Yeah. What have they given?
But there is no option like that, no sir.
Okay. Yeah, it should be B should also be R only.
Yes, sir.
Or if A is RS, then B should be also RS.
Yes, sir.
So ARBS, QP. QP is here, QP is here.
Then
so four can also be correct. That's for your knowledge.
Yes, sir.
Anyone else? Anything extra?
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, once could you scroll to 62?
I think we have done much better questions than 62.
No, sir. Inductive effect will be valid up to 3 carbons only, no, sir.
No, it is significant up to 3 carbon. It is always there. Are you getting a point?
Okay, sir.
Okay.
sir. So 75. So fifth one, sir.
It's localized lone pair, so it cannot be delocalized.
I so understood.
Yeah. Anything else?
Sir, 68.
Yeah, which one?
Sir, option one.
Option three also.
Phenoxide, I mean, this we have discussed, no? Equivalent and non-equivalent resonance. Here you will be getting equivalent resonating structure. Here, the moment you delocalize, you get negative charge on carbon with a non-aromatic ring. So other resonating structures won't be as stable as the original one. Are you getting a point?
Yes.
Okay, so one is OME is a stronger plus R. Plus R is plus M effect. Okay, so here the lone pair can go only this side. Here it can go here as well as here. Is it clear?
Sir.
Yeah.
So once again, could you explain fourth option?
168.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can look at this molecule. Okay, so you see, first we observe the molecular plane of symmetry. The molecular plane of symmetry will be like this. Are you getting a point? And let us take cis version, because cis is having the maximum possibility of having a plane of symmetry. But you see, if you take the molecular plane of symmetry, both CH3 are up only and both hydrogens are down only. So there is no mirror image of CH3 down the molecular plane of symmetry. Are you getting my point?
Sir, can't we take this?
You are talking at this one, no? The middle one.
Not that. This molecule of, I mean, light green one.
Huh? See, there are two ways. Either you take this vertical one or you take this one. You take molecular plane, this does not have a corresponding mirror image group here. Getting a point?
Understood, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And if you take a vertical plane of symmetry, this does not have any mirror image corresponding to here. Okay. So I guess we have discussed all the relevant points.
Sir.
Yeah.
70,
52. 52. 1 minute. Yes, 52. 10 minutes.
Sir, what is correct answer for that?
See, technically speaking, based on Fisher projection, the answer is correct only. But you see, it is natural that people can say that as per the IUPAC, because you see, when you are using RS...
Sir, as per IUPAC, it will be two only, no, sir. Because...
It will be one.
One, sir.
Two bromo, no? B will come first, then C will come.
Sir.
Okay. That your sir, point I... Yeah. Tell.
Sir, two will be R only, no, sir.
See, if you are taking this to be 1, then this is 2, this is R.
So if you take bromo,
the numbering should be from...
If you are starting a numbering from down, then chlorine gets the third position. 3 is R then. If you take numbering from up, then chlorine is the second position, you get R. Getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, there is no confusion which I am seeing here. Okay, but yeah, if you are following the IUPAC numbering, then the answer should be 1.
Sir?
Yeah.
In this question also, top and bottom, like both are CH3 only, no, sir. Then next step will be to take IUPAC only, no, sir.
Yes.
Then it should be only option 1, no, sir.
Yeah, sir. See, don't try to take, marks of other people. You know, if you are getting marks, it is good. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, 75.
Yeah, 75th.
In that CCSP.
The people who have said this question, their student must have marked option 2. Okay. So they won't take back that option. Everyone cares about their students. Say 75, which option?
Sir, CCl3- will itself lose chlorine and forms dichlorocarbene, sir, which is more stable. Then how CCl3-
See, they are asking the stability of carbonyl. They are not asking what will happen if this will go. It's not like intermediates, stable intermediates do not react further.
Sir, but it is trying to lose its chlorine.
It's not like that. See, the thing is that CCl3- is stable. That is why it is formed. Then in another step, it loses chloride and becomes CCl2. That is a different story. You cannot put that story in the stability comparison. Are you getting a point?
So, sir, we need to check CCl3- formation, not after what it happens. Right?
No. We have to check it based on electronic effects only. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
That's it.
Here, d-orbital resonance is only the reason, no, sir, in both four and seven options.
So I have given that CCl3- is more stable than CF3-.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir?
Yes.
In 52, why you are saying it will be option 2 also? Once again, can you?
Because generally, in Fisher projections are written in such a way that the highest number carbon is on the top. That's a general conversion. Yeah, I am getting your point. But the thing is that it is written in that way. So a lot of people think that our numbering should always be done from top to bottom in a Fisher projection. Is it clear? But
sir,
yeah.
In this writing case, the name of the compound when we include this R and S.
What did I say earlier? I'm saying that your point is correct. But I am telling you why option 2 is also considered by other people. Okay, technically should be answer 1 only. Okay.
I suggest for only 1.
Yeah. See, it's not like I am God that I will suggest and they will, you know, accept it only. I will put it from my side. Okay.
Sir, make sure that 1 and 2 are correct.
Okay, let us see it. You know, afterwards I will decide on what to do. Okay, I just want.
Sir, can you once again explain 71?
71. Is there a new section formed? VV1?
No, sir.
No. Okay. Yeah, 71. What's the issue in 71? Tell me.
Once again, can you explain?
See, a phenolic group will be something like this. Some R and then this whole group attached to it. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That can be, OH can be an ortho, meta or para.
Yes, sir.
So whatever is by R, it will have 3 isomers because of the rings.
Yes, sir.
Now, this ring is consuming 6 carbon and 1 oxygen. So
yes.
How many carbons are left? 2 carbon and 1 oxygen.
C8. Okay, so yes.
Out of that, 1 carbon will be the chiral carbon.
Yes, sir.
The other has to be CH3.
Yes, sir.
And OH okay. And H. That's the only possibility.
Yes, sir. Okay, understood.
Okay, now I want. Now, this is the whole paper discussion. Okay, I am stopping the recording now. Okay. Okay, so we are now live now. So today we are going to discuss UTA-9. Okay, and this paper is based on combined syllabus of GOC as well as isomerism. Okay, although the GOC part is only up to reactive intermediates. So most probably the questions of acids and bases are not there, but still it is a joint paper. So this whole paper consists of 3 sections. Section 1 is multi-correct answer type with partial marking. Section 2 is numerical value type. And section 3, which is comprehension type. Total, there are 18 questions. Okay, and we will start with the easiest of all, that is the comprehension type sections. So this is the way I will try to attempt the paper. Because comprehension type questions are single type, once you understand the thing, you can do two questions at a time. Okay. So paragraph question 33 and 34. Yeah, what is the doubt? Is there any doubt in 33, 34? Yes or no?
No, sir.
In all cases, it is the same minus I effect. Okay, only in case of CO minus, you'll have a plus I effect. Are you getting a point? So most unstable will be B and most stable will be C. So the order will be C greater than and B is last. Okay, benzene and carboxylic acid, benzene will have lesser minus I effect, C, D, A, B. Is it clear? Yes or no? Clear? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 34. Is it out?
No, sir.
The lone pair is SP2 lone pair, which is localized. So you have to only check for minus I effects. Okay, answer is 4312. Now, 35, 36, I think you can count the number of alpha hydrogens. Okay, so stability of alkene will be inversely proportional. So most stable alkene, they are asking, let's say. Then 36, carbon-carbon double bond length will be maximum. So more is the plus H effect, less will the bond order of C double bond C, because more will be the delta minus here. Okay, so more will be less will be more will be the carbon-carbon double bond length. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, so these last four, if you start with these four questions, you know, you will be getting a lot of confidence. And after that, we will jump back to the multi-correct. Okay, so in multi-correct, 19th, any doubts?
No, sir.
20th?
No, sir. No,
sir. So 20 B and C.
B and C. Okay, so what you are going to do is, you see, this is a not having any plane of symmetry, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay, so the only equivalent structure of this will be if you rotate it by 180 degree. Are you getting a point? So you'll be getting this structure. So either this or this will be representing the original molecule. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I have told you how to draw the Fisher projection of from wedge and dash. Do you remember it?
Yes.
What we do, we draw a line. Okay, and then we put that line vertical. Okay, and you see ET will be on top. Okay, and CH3 will be on bottom. Okay, now if you're rotating like this, BR and H both are this side. The solid dash will move towards the opposite side. Okay. And so it will be like this. Are you getting a point? Is it matching one of my two Fisher projections? The answer is yes. Similarly, yes, if I do something like this, then again, it will be CH3 and ET. Yes or no? Now, you see, this time the BR is on this side. Okay. And this VR is also on this side because it is dash one. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Do you want, so is it clear? 20th?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It's all about drawing the options. Draw it correctly, you'll get it. Then 21.
Sir, 21
option A is not true, sir. Why? If you have this molecule, okay, this is the molecule is something like this. CH2 double bond N O minus. Now, if I move it like this, then I will get this one. Yes or no?
Sir, here we're not checking for any stability or anything. Right? We're just drawing whatever is possible.
We are just looking for valid resonating structures.
Sir, actually, in option A, that carbon is not having octet, right? So, even that
in so the carbon doesn't have octet, no, sir.
Okay, lone pairs of oxygen are not shown. Its octet is complete in all the structures. Its octet means
oxygen. That's oxygen, no, sir. I'm oxygen, talking about carbon.
So that is only for oxygen, no, sir.
If it is saying
it's for oxygen, only. Is that clear? Sir,
I'm saying about carbon. Yeah, see, carbon octet need not to be complete in order to have a valid resonating structure.
Yeah, okay, sir.
All the carbocations do not have complete octet for carbon.
Yeah, okay, sir. Like permissible resonating structures means I thought even we should consider.
What are the things which I have discussed about? That any second period atom should not have more than 8 electrons. The number of unpaired electrons should not change. Are you getting a point?
Yeah, okay, sir. Only
so those two conditions. V is having 10 electrons around nitrogen, so that's why it's not there. Okay. So 21 is done. 22, 23, 24.
24, sir.
23. Yeah, all are having lone pair.
Sir, 24.
24, sir.
24. If carbon is connected to a metal, then carbon will be delta minus and metal will be delta plus. That metal is copper. And
yes, sir.
Is it clear? I have discussed the organometallic part, that if carbon is in an organometallic compound, when carbon-metal bond is there, then carbon will be containing negative charge and metal will be containing positive charge. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Option C, chlorine can show minus M effect, no, sir. Plus M effect.
It is not asking, it is asking polarity. This is not asking effect. Polarity means you have to see it on the basis of electronegativity, not talking about stabilization of phenyl. Are you getting a point? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, after this, you have
25, 26, 27.
Yeah, they're asking including stereoisomers. So you see, you have C6, so and it should be primary alcohol, means that CH2OH group is fixed. Okay, let us say this is the group G. I have a 5 carbon chain where I have to put G. Are you getting my point? So I draw a 5 carbon chain, what are the positions where I can put it? I can put it here, I can put it here, I can put it here. So this, this and this. Out of this, this is having what is this? A chiral center, so it will have 2 stereoisomers. Is it clear? Yes or no? This, this, and this.
Yes, sir.
Then I can have a 4 carbon chain and one side atom like this. Yes, here I can put it here. Okay. I can put it here. I can put it here and I can put it here. So based on this, I have gotten drawn the 4 structures. This, 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 and this. Okay, here this is a chiral center, so 2. This does not have any chiral center, so 1. This also does not have any chiral center, so 1. This is having a chiral center, so 2. This carbon is chiral. Is it clear? Yes,
sir.
No?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and the last one is this one. Okay, where I can take a 4 degree carbon and 4 CH3 around it. And one of them is, so here only one possibility is there. So it is this one. It is not chiral, it is achiral. So total is 2 plus 2, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. Okay. And 7, 8, 9. Okay. What have they given as answers? 11.
Yes.
1 minute. C's 5. We had 11 stereoisomers. 1 minute. So, 2 here. 2, 4, 6, 8. No, it is 11 only, no?
There can be one more isomer with four carbon chain and ethyl group attached.
That I have drawn here, no? This one. All these are four carbon chain with an alkyl group attached.
The ethyl group, sir.
How can you have a four carbon chain with ethyl group attached? Then it will be six carbon chain.
They are asking six carbon chain only, no, sir.
See, out of six carbon chain, one is CH2OH group. I can't disturb CH2OH. Are you getting a point? Because they are asking for 1 degree alcohols.
Sir, how many chiral centers?
We can have, no, sir.
What am I saying? That if you are, they are asking only for primary alcohols, not secondary alcohols. Are you getting on? With wherever OH is there, CH2 has to be part of it. Are you getting on? You cannot put OH in the middle of the carbon chain. It has always as CH2. So I have taken CH2OH out. Now I can only have a 5 carbon chain left and I have to put CH2OH among those 5 atoms only. Are you getting a point?
We can draw 2-ethyl butanol also.
What?
2-ethyl butanol.
Try to draw 2-ethyl butanol for me. Draw. Do you want me to draw 2-ethyl butanol? This is butane. Hold. Where is 2-ethyl? Okay. So, tell me.
Sir, I have already drawn it now.
I have taken care of all the structures. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
This approach, you won't miss anything. Because first I'm drawing a 5-carbon chain, then I'm drawing a 4-carbon chain, then a 3-carbon chain. So there's no possibility of missing anything. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So instead of randomly drawing, draw it in a systematic manner. First, draw a chain isomer. For each chain isomer, look for positional isomer. For each positional isomer, look for GI and optical isomers, depending on how many chiral centers you are having. If you have only one chiral center, it will have two stereo isomers. If you have two chiral centers, then you can have 3 or 4, depending on symmetry. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Can you scroll up?
Yes.
Yeah, you want to write the structures? Are you getting how I am approaching this problem? That is more important.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I know that I have to keep CH2OH as a single group. So I have given that carbon to OH. Now I am only left with 5 carbon. I have to arrange it in such a way that I can form any alkyl chain. I am counting the number of alkyl chains in that case. Is it clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is done. Question number 26. They're asking number of geometrical isomers in this case. Well, the number of geometrical isomers will be also equal to number of fractions. Okay, so let us look into this. Now you see, you have a 4-carbon chain, butane. They're only asking N-butane. Are you getting my point? They're not asking all of the formula C4H8Br2. They are only asking N-butane, means I have to only take N-butane as the parent chain. Now, if I am doing bromination, what are the possibilities? I can have a bromine here or here. Yes or no? I have drawn a bromine here and I have drawn a bromine here. Is it clear? Yes or no? Now, the second bromine has to be added to this. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
What are
the
possibilities? I can add it here, I can add it here, I can add it here, I can add it here. Similarly, here, what are the possibilities? I can add it here, 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 and here. Is it clear? Yes or no? Now, obviously,
yes,
there will be some overlapping. Okay, so let us see. First, draw. So you see, if I'm drawing it here, you will get this, then you will get this, this, and this. Okay, these are the four corresponding to these. And if I'm drawing, these are the four. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let us see it for the common. Are you getting this one anywhere? This one is also here. So this is gone. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
This is getting repeated. This is not getting repeated. This is not getting repeated, but this is getting repeated here. So these are gone. These are what? These are positional isomers or structural isomers. Are you getting a point? I've written all the structural isomers.
Yes, sir.
Now, I have to check for each structure whether it is having, you know, diastereomers or not. Okay, so if I'm talking about this, this is having a one chiral center. Now, you see, you need two chiral centers to have diastereomers or geometrical isomers. Are you getting a point? With one chiral center, you'll only get what? Enantiomers?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is only having enantiomer. This is not having any chiral center. This is having two chiral centers and it is symmetrical. So it will have two geometrical isomers. Yes or no? Or two fractions? Yes, no. Meso and DL?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. Now here, this is having one chiral center. But only one fraction because it won't have any GI. In this case, this will is having one, this is having one. So total is 1, 2, 3, 2, 5, 1, 6, and 1, 7. Are you getting a point? Yes, no.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Question number 27. The answer should be 12.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. These two are not stereogenic center. I think we have discussed it earlier. Rigid carbon atoms, we cannot change the configuration because exchanging of groups will lead to increase in the ring strength. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, these two won't be answered. Answer will be 12. But you see, what they have done, you know, based on whatever I have seen over the last two or three papers, because this is a distinction which you know, not a lot of teachers will also recognize that not all chiral centers are stereogenic. I have told you, right?
Yes, sir.
Some chiral centers can be astereogenic. Okay, for example, and non-chiral centers can be stereogenic. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I think we have discussed all those things in the lectures itself. So you people should be clear on these things. Okay, in Chaitanya papers, so I don't know. Let us see. Okay, I will give the corrections from my side, but the answer should be 12 only. Okay, after this, 28.
So I'm getting only 5, sir.
No, you'll be getting
yes, sir.
5 normal structures and 1 based on that. Now, I have told you people to use the strategy. Whatever are the normal structures which we have drawn during practice, you should draw. So let me draw the 5 normal structures. Okay. So you have O minus. First, just draw the structure of O minus without thinking of CHO group. I will tell you where the structures will come. Okay. No, 1 minute. This is O minus. Okay. Then this is with double bond O. This will be going this side, so you'll get a minus charge. Then you'll get double bond O. This will be going this. I'll draw the arrows also, but let me first draw this. Then I will draw, this will go this. You get a negative charge here. Okay, and then this will go here, this will go here. These are the 5 official structure of phenoxide and yes or no? Okay. Now I am drawing the CHO group here. I see most of the cases CHO group won't even participate in the resonance. Okay. Except this one. Are you getting a point? Only in this case, now I can draw the arrows. Okay, so you see this arrow is going here, This is going here. This is going here. This is going here. Okay. This is going here. This is going here. This is going here. This is going here. Is it clear? Okay. Now you see, when this arrow is there, this goes here and this goes here. So you get the six structure. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it will be something like this. This is a stepwise way of doing the things. Okay, let me have some more space. I have to try to get up. Because you see, it is something like this. O minus H double bond. Is that clear? This is the sixth one. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, 29. Not a doubt. 30.
So 30.
Yeah, lowest bond dissociation energy, most stable radical. This radical at 5 is being stabilized by 2 phenyl rings and 1 hyperconjugation also. So if you want me to write the order, okay, let us write the order. That is the only interesting thing. 5 is most stable, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, what is the least stable one? Least stable will be SP radical?
7th.
Then 8th. Okay. And then 1. Because 1 is a vinyl radical. Okay. Then after 5, we should be more stable. I think phenyl radical 6. Is benzyl. No. 6 should not be more stable. See, allyl radical is more stable than benzyl radical. So 2 degree allyl is more stable than... So this is a 3 degree allyl radical, 4th. After 5, it should be 4. Okay, then it should be 2. And then it should be 6. Okay, and then it should be 3. Is it clear?
So one second.
See, 5 is more stable. Now, we know that allyl radical, 1 degree allyl is more stable than 1 degree benzyl. In radicals, that is the yes, order sir. Of stability.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, 2 degree allyl will be more stable than 2 degree benzyl.
Yes, this, sir.
4 is a 3 degree allyl radical. And 2 is a 2 degree allyl radical. So, it will be more stable than benzyl.
Yes, sir.
4 will be more than 2. And then 6 will come. And then 3. That is the only thing left. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 31. Not a doubt?
No doubt, sir.
32.
No doubt, sir.
Okay. So 32, here the positive charge should be here. Okay. MuH, NH3, and CO. These are... CO is a ligand. It is a Lewis base because of its lone pair. Are you getting a point?
Yes.
That's why it forms carbonyl complexes. Okay, so that is why it is acting as a nucleophile. With this, I think we have discussed almost everything which is there in this paper. And yeah, anything else you want to ask?
Sir,
yes.
Sir, CO2.
CO2 is a can act as an electrophile as well as nucleophile. I think I've discussed this point in the class notes.
Br2.
Polar pi bond. Br2 is having bromine vacant d orbitals. It can act as an electrophile. No?
Yes.
Cl2, Br2, I2. All three can act as electrophiles. They can accept electrons. That is precisely what happens in the electrophilic aromatic substitution. Are you getting a point?
Yes.
Yes,
sir. So with this, I
sir.
Believe that, yeah.
So once again, could you explain 33rd one?
33rd one. Yeah, it is based on minus I think because there is no conjugation here. All these are sp3 carbons. So NOT is minus I, benzene is minus I, COH is minus I, CO minus is plus I.
Yes,
I think
sir.
We discussed this in the notes.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir, I understood.
So I think with this, we are done with the paper discussion today. Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think in this whole paper, the only bone of contention is question number 27, right? Yes, sir. Apart from that, all the things are good. 27 is something which I don't expect a lot of teachers to appreciate. But, you know, you people know the current thing. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So that is more important for me. All chiral centers are not stereogenic. Okay. Bridget chirals are definitely not stereogenic. Apart from that also, we have discussed which chiral centers are not stereogenic when we gave the pseudo chiral center example. Okay, so with this, I'm ending today's class. Thank you, people, for taking out time on Sunday to attend this paper discussion. Okay. And so now you can enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you, people.
Thank you, sir.
Okay,
thank you, sir.
So let me just finish.